Well, thank you for all of the entries in our Hatchimals contest. During the week, Michelle and I were talking about how tough these things were to get.
People are standing outside in the freezing cold to get these.
So we talked about it on the air. We had a beautiful, wonderful, lovely listener from Jersey City, Joy, who drove them down here and sold them to us. And I said, hey, I'll buy two for some desperate parents. And voila, here we have two Hatchimals. And the two lucky winners were Tammy from Middletown and Susan from Beechwood.
And thank you, everybody, for emailing, and a lot of people emailed in.
And we have both of their stories live on the air on the link below. And thanks again for joining. If we could give one away every hour from now until Christmas, we would. A Merry Christmas to all, and thank you for entering the contest. So winner number one is Tammy Leopoldi from Middletown, New Jersey. So Tammy, welcome. Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Tammy.
Hi, Tammy.
Congratulations.
Hi. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. You've wrote a very funny little thing appealing for this toy. So tell us a little bit about yourself and why you wanted this toy.
Okay. So last year, my daughter, after we bought her all her Christmas presents, after she opens all her gifts, she tells us Santa didn't bring her a guitar. And I was like, what guitar? You never told us you wanted a guitar. I had no idea. I felt so bad. But Santa had to drop this guitar off on New Year's Day, a week late. So this year, I'm like, I'm
so she had
like,
secretly
really
like she had secretly prayed to Santa for a guitar?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And I was supposed to know about that.
Right.
I didn't know. So this year, I made sure I listened really closely, got everything on that list. I was all finished shopping. And Friday, she heard Hatchimal on the radio, and she tells me Santa's bringing her Hatchimal. I don't even know what Hatchimal is. That's when I go home, I start researching, and I find out this is that Cabbage Patch Kid of the 80s, the Tickle Me Elmo of the 90s. That toy you can't get.
That's when you start to panic as a parent. You're like, what am I going to do?
Oh, yeah. So I tried to find it online. I went to Target at 7 in the morning to find out these parents were camped out from 11 o'clock the night before. I'm like, there's no way I'm going to be able to get this thing. My last resort was going to be to put my little Maltese in an egg and have him hatch. I was getting desperate.
Well, the animal that comes out of this is a half, it plays the guitar. So that might.
that she'll love that. She'll
it's half so a happy. Guitar player and half a drummer. No, you have no idea what comes out until you rub it, right?
I think it kind of looks like a Furby from what I understand.
It's sitting in front of me. I have no idea what it is. But listen, you got it. We'll have to make arrangements for when you come pick them up or how we'll get them to you in Middletown, okay?
Great. Thank you so much, guys. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. Congratulations. Hold on, Danny. We'll figure out how we do this, how we get you the Hatchimals. All right, so our other winner, the chosen by our panel of judges, is Susan Stetsko. Susan Stetsko is from Beechwood, New Jersey. Let's get Susan on the line. Hello, Susan.
Hi, Susan.
Hi, how are you today?
Good, how are you?
Good. Thank you so much for this opportunity. It really means a lot.
Well, you made at least a half dozen people cry who read your story.
Oh, my God. I hope I don't cry today.
Do you want to tell us a little bit without getting too...
Yes, I will. First, I'd like to say the family is very proud, and they really don't ask for anything. In the summer, my mother had told me a story. She lives in a community, and one of the women in the community, in the adult community, her son had come down with cancer. And he has a little boy who's under the age of 10. There's no mom in the picture. The little boy chooses to live with his dad, and, you know, he goes through the whole thing, helps him, takes care of him. There is family. I mean, they're not living alone or anything like that. There is family. So that in itself shows you the character of this little guy. I mean, under the age of 10, I think that just warms my heart of what, you know, he is. Unfortunately, about 3 weeks ago, Dad was diagnosed with cancer again. I guess it metastasized itself. So things are not going well there. Dad was self-employed, so so we all know what medical costs are.
Sure.
And the family is all pitching in to do that. So this gift is so extravagant that the family would not be able to even think about that for him. Never mind getting one. As your last caller said, I'm sorry, I don't remember her name.
Tanner.
But yeah, he's such a precious little boy.
Well, Susan, you are a sweetheart for going out of your way to do this
for
the family. Hang on, we'll figure out how to get it to you in Beechwood.
Thank you.
And thank you
so much.
Oh, you're welcome. Hold on.
Oh, my goodness. I'm so glad that he's going to be able to get this toy.
That's nice.
Just a small thing. But
you know what? I wish we could do this every day, all day.
Me too.
I really do. All right. I'm trying to help in a little way. So congratulations to Susan and to Tammy. And thank you all for the people who entered the contest. Like I said, if I could give away hundreds of them, I'd do it every day, all day.